We are back again with another challenge video for the Cytosin versus mission in Hokkaido. This one will cover Jegsana Hendik. A bit of a stretch. Sushi Honshu style. What's up, dog? Smell something fishy? Mission Story Hot Springs. Mission Story Thrill Seekers. Namaste. And Tech Man. We'll start undercover as a chef in the kitchen. We'll smuggle in a silenced pistol in the freezer. So let's get started out of the cutscene right away. We'll grab that kitchen knife off the counter. Go ahead and hide up against this wall so the other chefs don't see through your disguise while he's walking around the equipment. We'll come into the freezer and make sure you cut the fish first before you grab your pistol. If you grab the pistol and then cut the fish, there is a well-known bug that's been around since the 2016 game that will crash your game, and it works damn near every time. I really can't believe it's actually still around, but I've experienced it quite a few times, even in Hitman 3. And we'll just wait out this camera and run to the right of it when it's looking the other way. We'll run down to the garage.
You always fill me with such calm. Looking at the fish.
We'll grab the wrench that's off the little toolbox here. And then we'll head upstairs. This is the little room that the yoga instructor hangs out in, but we're going to turn around and go down the hallway through the hospital to the back door to where the sauna controls are. We'll heat up the sauna. We'll go ahead and use this wrench on this pipe that's over here, and that will heat up the water out in the pool. We'll wait for these two guys to get all the way out of the sauna, because we have to pull the fire alarm, and if we do while they're still in there, they'll just stay in there with that high heat and end up dying. Go ahead and pull the fire alarm. Once everybody settles down, they'll actually sit in a little circle right outside that door. We can come over here, and there's this little clipboard with a piece of paper on it that usually starts the mission story, but I think because everybody's flipping out right now, it's not going to. But that's okay, because the yoga instructor will stand over between doors over here and make a phone call, and that will also reveal the mission story for us. Alright, now it looks like everybody's calmed down and they'll go sit in a little circle. And that will make the Namaste challenge pop up. And we'll go back into here and listen to the yoga instructor make his phone call. And it looks like Yuki is going to be on her way here now, so hopefully he hurries up so we can reveal the mission story before she gets here.
Terry, it's John. Listen, I need your help, buddy. Well, I tried that pose we talked about, Destroyer of the Universe. Well, it sort of backfired. I was feeling so good this morning, too. I just felt so centered and so pure. And then the director came up and asked me to grab a lesson with Yuki Yamazaki, that Yakuza lawyer who's staying here I told you about. Oh, bad karma, man, just terrible karma. Well, I'm not sure what happened exactly. I thought I had it, but then somehow I pulled something back there. No, back there. I can't walk very well now, and...
She's inspecting the sauna, and since nobody's in there, she will actually get in the sauna this time.
Dodging calls from the director all morning, so I just need a favor. I need you to go.
Well, it's a...
Now that that mission story is revealed, let's go ahead and we'll run over to the sauna real quick, and right outside the door, we'll make a save. Hit the button prompt to hold the door shut and kill her inside of there.
Open this door! Are you insane? Let me out, right? Now let me out! No.
That will get us the Jeg Sauna Hand Ick Challenge.
Now it's time for Sodas to retire.
Now we can go ahead and load up our save. We'll run back out of here and get the yoga instructor disguise.
No, don't get mom, Terry.
Please!
I'll try to knock him out from behind, but I guess we didn't lose SA this time, so that's good. I'm gonna drag his body all the way to the bottom of the stairs since there's a lady inside that room where the closet is. Go ahead and take his disguise and talk to Yuki before she gets across the hallway.
I believe you booked time for a yoga lesson.
Yes. To be honest, I was beginning to wonder if you're ever going to show. Glad you're here.
If you will just follow me.
Okay.
And once we're back into the main sauna area, let's run around and shut most of the doors. Then we can walk out onto this platform. Once she's out here and her bodyguard is out here, we'll run back and shut that door. Now we'll finish off the mission story. The bodyguard will have his back turned so we don't have to worry about him seeing us push her off the ledge.
Let's begin.
Go ahead and begin the yoga session.
Let us begin with upward facing dog.
And then just keep hitting the button prompts for the different yoga positions.
Fluid movement. Very good. Now, transition into Lord of the Dance. Remember to breathe throughout. Warrior 2 pose. Core. Strength. Stay there for a while.
Jason Portman. Please come to the hospital entrance.
Changing sides.
A doctor will escort you to your checkup. That was for Mr. Jason Portman.
And finally,
a doctor will escort you to your upward.
Tree is the final position.
Proceed to the hospital.
And you can pretty much push her off the ledge anytime. I like to wait until after she says, "Now this is a view to die for."
Now, this is a view to die for.
Once you kick her over the ledge, that will get us a bit of a stretch challenge. And we'll go ahead and load up our save after all that.
Okay, this is too much.
And from here, let's go run over to the sushi bar.
Don't get mom, Terry.
Right over here on the counter is the sushi that we have to poison and feed to Yuki. But first, we're gonna head downstairs and reveal the mission story.
Yeah, the cake's alright.
Right in this room, there will be another chef talking about how he can't serve the boo-boo fish.
I don't know. The patient did die. Famous one at that.
Still, it's not the chef's fault.
What was a kitchen apprentice thinking, cutting out a fugu fish by himself unsupervised? I mean, it takes years of practice. Didn't the kid realize how poisonous those things are?
Yeah, he's a kid. I mean, well, probably wanted to show off. I don't know. But anyway, the hospital administration probably thought it would be better to just ban serving fugu altogether.
Poor chef. That was his best party trick. Now, what do we do with the last fugu?
Throw it out, I guess. It's a damn shame, too. The chef had to refuse serving Yuki Yamazaki his signature dish. I mean, despite her constant requests. She asked about it just an hour ago. It's really too bad.
Well,
Gama has banned the serving of...
Once we have that revealed, it will still be quite a while until Yuki gets over to the sushi bar, so let's go run up into the morgue and grab the screwdriver. We'll use that for the Tech Man challenge later on.
Hey, so you're the curator's research.
As long as that guy's looking down at his clipboard, we should be able to sneak by. The screwdriver's right over here in this room.
Mr. Jason Park. Does it work? Please come to the hospital entrance.
Since we're down here, we may as well shoot the camera box and not have to worry about any cameras anymore.
That was for Mr. Jason.
Now we can run back outside and up the stairs to the sushi bar.
Please proceed to the hospital entrance.
Go ahead and poison the sushi. Then we'll hit the other button prompt to prepare the sushi. That will finish off our mission story. And since she's still quite a ways away, we'll go ahead and just fast forward until she gets here. And once she's up to the counter, a button prompt will pop up to serve her sushi.
Excuse me. Would you like to try our delicious sushi?
Once you hit that, she'll come over and eat it. She'll walk away a little bit before she actually keels over and dies from the poison.
I knew you would come around eventually. Good for you.
I hope you like it. My colleague is a straight arrow. Me, I say it's good to live dangerously.
You took the words right out of my mouth. That's exactly right. Smooth velvet softness. Absolutely delicious. My compliments to the chef.
You, Mr. Dexter.
Once she falls over and dies, that will get us the sushi honshu style challenge. Now that we're done with that, let's run back downstairs and we'll start taking care of the Tech Man challenge. And do keep in mind that you do have to be in a resort staff disguise to end up dancing on it after we're done killing the first guy with it. We can grab that from the little wardrobe room here. We'll open this door and shoot a bunch of bullets at the floor, and then we'll get the two guys out of there so we can run in and sabotage the pad with our screwdriver.
Hey, wake up! Go somewhere safe. We may have a situation.
Then we'll just run back in here and hide in the closet while the guards search around. And now that that's over, we can get out of there. And once these guys are back in the room, we still have to turn the console to expert mode, so let's distract the enforcer guy out of there.
I cannot accept when people are just...
And then we could run in here, hit the button prompt to activate expert mode. That's what makes him dance fast enough to get electrocuted by the pad. Otherwise, it won't work.
Whatever.
Yeah.
Once he gets electrocuted and dies, a prompt will pop up over the pad to actually repair it. But we'll have to wait for the body to get dragged away, and then we'll distract that enforcer guy out of there again and knock him out.
Command! Think there's been an accident. Copy that. Situation is contained. Just one of those.
Now
days.
That he's dragging the body away, let's make sure that door is open and toss a distraction in here.
Is that those bloody kids messing around here?
We'll knock him out and hide his body so we can have the game room to ourselves.
Hello?
Hit the button prompt on the dance pad to repair it. And now hit the button prompt once again to perform the ritual. That will get us the Tech Man Challenge. And that will conclude today's video. Thanks everybody for watching. If you have any questions, requests, or comments, feel free to leave them down below. If you liked this video and found this video helpful, feel free to hit that thumbs up button. If you enjoy the content that I produce and want to keep up with any future videos or projects that I'm working on, go ahead and hit that subscribe button.